প্রদীপ সরকার, দিস ইজ নীলোৎপল চক্রবর্তী অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ প্রদীপ্ত মশাট, উই আর ফ্রম সেন্ট থমাস কলেজ অফ ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং।
আই এম বৈদ্যনাথ, দিস ইজ অভিনী মুখোপাধ্যায় অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ দেবশ্রী অ্যান্ড উই আর রিপ্রেজেন্টিং সেন্ট থমাস কলেজ অফ ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং অ্যান্ড টেকনোলজি।
Hello everyone, I am Mehul and on my left is Samarth and on my right is Ishant.
Hi everyone, this is Avinash Mishra. To my left is Nivandu Kaur and to my right is Shoma Mojumdar and we are representing Heritage Institute of Technology, Kolkata.
Hello everyone, myself Akash Das, he is Ritik and in my left, Prithviraj Vishwas, we are from JIS University.
Great, thank you teams. Team 4. Team 6, Team 7, Team 8, fine. Now I tell you what is at stake today. The winners will take home YONO scholarships of each team member will take home 6,000 rupees per month. Total amount will be 1,44,000 for 1 year. And the third prize winners will take home rupees 12,000. That is a one-time scholarship of rupees 4,000 per team member for 1 month. Fine. Now, let me begin with the rules for the quiz. We will do this quiz on infinite pounds. There will be 10 questions clockwise. Then there will be an acrostic round, SBI YONO Cube. I'll tell you when we get there. Then there will be a buzzer round. That is the third round. And the fourth round will be an anti-clockwise round with 10 questions. The first round and the fourth round, they are on infinite pounds. You know, everybody knows what infinite pounds is. I'll just briefly tell you for the benefit of the audience. Infinite pounds is a format in quizzing in which, suppose, the direct question is for team 1. So, the 7 other teams can also, if they know the answer, they can raise their hand and write the answer on the paper. So everybody gets a fair chance to answer all the questions. So that way it's a very fair way of doing the quiz. And 2 questions, if they go unanswered from a team, then it will pass to the next team. The third question will be to the next team. Okay? If a question goes unanswered twice, if 2 questions goes unanswered. Fine? The time limit to pounds will be 5 seconds actually. Once I finish reading the question, you will get almost 5 seconds to pounds and then I will close the pounds. Pounds will have plus 10 and minus 10 and I will need the full answer. Okay, the correct keywords for the pounds if you are pouncing. And in the buzzer round, the scoring will be different, plus 7 and minus 5. But for all other rounds, it will be plus 10 and minus 10. Fine. You raise your hands, write on the paper, and I'll come to you and see the answer. Okay? So we start. Please give a big round of applause to the finalists and SBI YONO. First round is Launchpad. Other teams can pounce. Question coming up now. Hagoromo Bungu was originally founded in October 1932 in Nagoya. The factory was destroyed by a war in the decade that followed. It was then re-established in 1965 by Ryuzo Watanabe with the office and factory located in Kasugai. Mathematician Satyen Devados wrote in 2010 that Hagoromo can be called the Michael Jordan of Dash, the Rolls Royce of Dash. They are one of the largest producers and distributors of what commonly used item. I am closing the pounds in 3, 2, 1. Only team 2 has pounds. Please write the answer. Team 1, it's a direct. Chalk. Chalks is correct. Excellent answer by team 1 and team 2 found it correct also. So plus 10 to team 1 and plus 10 to team 2. Scorers, please note, team 1 gets a plus 10 and team 2 gets a plus 10. Now the next question goes to team 2. Meltdown is the title of the second release and first full-length album by American singer-songwriter Steve Taylor. What does the title of the song refer to? I'm closing the palms in 3, 2, 1, palms closed, direct for team 2.
So we're going to say this is a reference to nuclear accident and nuclear meltdown falling when a reactor goes bump.
Okay, that's not the answer I'm looking for. Team 3?
Chernobyl reactor meltdown.
No, it's more or less the same which team 2 said. You just added a name, Chernobyl. Team 4? Passing. Team 5? Passing. Team 6?
Fukushima meltdown.
No. Team 7?
Mental breakdown of musicians before concerts.
No. Team 8? Okay, audience, anybody? Oh, sorry. Team 1. Yeah, sorry.
So climate change in general, global warming, climate change?
No, that is not the answer. Yeah. Couldn't get you? Madame Tussauds. And what about that? Excellent answer. Please give him a prize.
Chakravarti ko salam, Chhatrapati ko salam. Chakravarti ko salam, Chhatrapati ko salam, Mahavir ko salam, Ranadhir ko salam, Samrat ko salam, Jahanpanaha ko salam, salam.
Alright, so I can see teams 1, 3, 6, 1, 3 and 6 pouncing, right? Please write your answers, I am coming.
The movie Gopi Gawaiya Bhaga Bachaiya based on Gopi Gawaiya Bhaga Bachaiya.
Excellent. That is correct. The answer is Gopi Gayan Bhaga Bhai. So plus 10 to teams 1, 2, 3 and 6. 1, 3 and 6 had pounced and they got it correct. And team 2 answered it correctly on the direct. So 1, 2, 3 and 6 get plus 10 on this question. Next question for team 3. He was the fourth child after three daughters, Apurupa, Sarojini and Nani Bala. Two previous sons had died in infancy. Going along with them, prevailing rural folk custom to avoid mortality, the mother symbolically gave up all social rights on her only surviving male child and sold the baby to her eldest daughter, Apurupa, for 3 handfuls of X or food grain. Thus, the baby was bought in exchange of X and was brought up wholly from that moment by his elder sister. Now, name this famous Indian. It's a direct for team 3. I'm closing the pounds. I've closed the pounds. Team number 1 and 2 have pounds. Please write your answer. So, team 3, this is a direct.
3 handfuls of khud, so this is Khudiram Basu.
Okay. Excellent. Correct answer by team 3. So team 1 and team 3 have answered it correctly. The answer is Shahid Khudiram Bose. Khud means broken rice grains. And team 2 gets a negative, minus 10. They answered it wrongly. Scorers, please note, team 1 and 3 get plus 10 and team 2 gets minus 10. The next question is for team 1. Theory for the origin of this term comes from the part of the hotel seen in the picture, dating back to when President Ulysses S. Grant was a regular, drinking whiskey and smoking cigar there, and political advocates used to come to meet him there. What term? Pounce is closed. Team number 1, 2, 3, 6 and 7 have pounced. Thank you. Excellent. Correct answer by team 4. That is the lobby of a hotel, and the term lobbying came up from this. So team number 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 7 get plus 10 on this question. Scorers, please note, team number 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 7 is correct as of now. The newer name was introduced by the Bangladeshi government to do away with the colonial baggage and slowly but surely phase it out with the Bengali version of the name. What lexicon decision made by the Bangladeshi government in 2018 are we talking about? Answer. Chittagong and Chittagong. Excellent. Correct answer there by team 6. They changed Chittagong to Chattogram or Chattgaon. I mean, both are correct versions. So team 6 gets plus 10. Question for team 7. Seen here is the congenital air condition, which often presents as a thickening of the helix. Who depicted this in his work and theorized that the feature is atavistic, that is evolutionary repetition of a feature. Who? I need the blank. Team 7.
Turner.
Not Turner. Team 8.
MC Isha.
Constable. Constable.
No. Team 3.
Pass.
4. No. Team 5.
Michelangelo.
No. Team 6. This was a question for team 7, I suppose. Audience, anybody? Yeah.
Thomas Woolner.
Thomas?
Woolner.
And? What Woolnerian, is the term?
Woolnerian trip.
Excellent. Dunsfold Aerodrome was built by the Canadian as a Class A bomber airfield for Army Cooperation Command. It was
test atom bombs.
Test atom bombs?
Test bombs in general.
Okay. No. Team 8.
Winter Olympics.
To?
Yeah, use it as a venue for Winter Olympics.
No. This will be too small for a sport like Olympics. Anyway. Team 2.
So you get flights here to visit the Niagara Falls.
No. Nothing to do with the Niagara Falls. Team 3.
Use as a track for Carnegie and Grand Prix.
That's but wrong one. Team 4. Rather than refute the case of the prosecutor, it's an intentional distraction. On the right, you can see a caricature of Johnny Cochran uses the F defense against Chef, lends his name to this defense. Alright. I'm closing the pounds. Pounds closed. Team number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 7 have pounds, right? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 7. Write your answers. Get 10 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 and 8. Yeah, 6 teams. Sorry. 6th question of the first round. Going to team number 1. At the tip of each arm is an eye that can detect changes in light intensity. And on the bottom are tube feet that enable it to move in any direction. Several of their species can regenerate an arm lost to a predator or an accident, and a few can even regenerate a whole new central disc from a severed arm, as long as a fragment of the disc remains with the arm. This is the explanation behind what? Why starfish are shaped like stars? Yeah. So we have come to an end of round one. I have audience question now. While many mistake an American startup to be the sponsors of this event, which major international badminton competition is actually named after the former player who conceptualized the tournament way back in 1957?
Sir?
Yes.
Uber Cup.
Excellent. That is the Uber Cup. It was named after former women's badminton player Betty Uber. Another question. Smell come to manhood. Commercials show mother singing about... Excellent. This is the empty nest syndrome. So now we have come to the end of round one. Can we have the scores? Okay, we'll have the scores after round two. Okay. Team one. Teams, please tally the scores. Team 1 is on 60, Team 2 is on 30, Team 3 is on 40, Team 4 is on 20, Team 5 is yet to open the count, Team 6 is on 30, Team 7 is on 20, and Team 8 is on 10. These are just the early days. Are the scores okay, teams? Fine? Great. From the word, you select S. So the answer will be starting from S. Okay? So there are 8 questions and there are 8 teams. This is not on pounds, this is only on bounce. A dash is the personal representative of a head of state or government who prepares an international summit, particularly the annual G7 and G20 summits. Between the G7 summits, there are multiple conferences where possible agreements are laid out. This reduces the amount of time and resources required at the negotiations of the heads of the state at the final summit. The name is a reference to the fact that they clear the way for a head of state at a major summit. Fill in the blank. Excellent answer, team 2. This is indeed Sherpa. Sherpa clears the way for their bosses to the summit. Team 2, your question, this will be for team 3. Yeah, bounce. A dog produces an unusual yodel-like sound, commonly known as a baru, due to its unusually shaped larynx. Yeah, team 3.
So it's a Belgian Malinois.
No, it's not the Belgian Malinois. Team 4.
Basenji.
Excellent answer, team 4. It is the Basenji. That's the soundless dog, as they say. Now, since team 4, the name of the movie starts with I.
Into the space.
No, you are actually not looking at the question. You see what has been blanked out. Okay? Team 6. Passing. Team 7.
Intoxicated,
no. Team 8.
Incense.
No. Team 1. Passing. 2.
Ill.
Not ill. Team 3.
Ice.
Not ice. Team 4.
Insurgents.
Not insurgents. Audience. Yes, one with the black shirt. IO is correct. The answer is IO. So this one goes without an answer. Sacrifices for his father. The one who obeys, surrenders, submits is a good son because obedience is one of the highest value. Father is the tradition and he must be followed and his mistakes are to be forgiven. There are numerous examples of dash complex in Indian mythology where Ram abdicates his throne because Dasharath wants to maintain his integrity and tells Ram to, where Bhishma takes a vow of celibacy because Kunti wants the sun god to make her children the kings. So fill in the blank, what complex am I talking about? It starts with a Y from Indian mythology. Team 5. Team 5, are you answering? Passing team 5, team 6?
Yayati.
Excellent answer, team 6. This is the Yayati complex. So plus 10 for team 6. Question for team 6. The name of which board game comes from the French and German word for yes? Team 7. It starts with a O.
Ouija.
Excellent. Yes. Correct answer there by team 7. Ouija is the correct answer. Plus 10 to team 7, which begins with a N. The N Memorial was created by 43-year-old Manjeet Singh Gill, a sculptor who left his government job to create statues of inspirational personalities, including former President Abdul Kalam, Milkha Singh, Mahatma Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, Shahid Bhagat Singh, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, etc. It was the only memorial in the entire nation built in her memory. Identify the famous Indian. name starts with an N. This is the only monument in the entire country which is dedicated to her. So a female starts with an N, teammate. Teammate, passing, team 1.
Sarojini Naidu.
Sarojini Naidu. Okay, so the surname starts with N. No. Team 2.
Nivedita Memorial.
Nivedita, as in sister Nivedita. No, no. Team 3. Excellent. This is Nidya Bhanot. This is the only monument dedicated to Nidya Bhanot. So, a plus 10 to team 3. Question for team 4. Again, the manufacturer Nestle says that the bar was introduced by George Williamson and his Williamson Candy Company of Chicago in 1920 in US. The candy was actually named after a boy who frequented George Williamson's second candy shop and not after an American literary figure. Now, which candy brand am I talking about? Starts with a team 4. Correct. Team 4 gets it correct. It's O. Henry, and not to be mingled with O. Henry, the book. Okay, so team 4 gets a plus 10. And the last question of this round to team 5, the answer begins with a Q. What is the name of this traditional European pole weapon and a technique of stick fighting? Starts with a Q. Are you answering team 5? Passing. Team 6?
Quidditch.
Not Quidditch. Team...
Coyote.
No. Team 8? Passing. Team 1?
Quarrel.
No. Team 3?
Question.
Not question. Team 4?
I'm guessing Quenelle or something.
No. So this was for team 5. Anybody in the audience want to try? Yes, the lady there. Nothing that sounds like quingling or something. I mean, I haven't. No, that is not the answer. Yeah? The gentleman in the check shirt.
Quarterstaff.
Quarterstaff is correct. Excellent answer there. Please give him a big hand. Quarterstaff is the answer. Now we go back to the page. And before that, we also see the score. The score after round 2. Team, can we have the scores? Yeah. So team 1 is on 60, team 2 is on 40, team 3 is on 50, team 4 is on 40, team 3 is yet to open their account, team 6 is on 40, team 7 is on 30, team 8 is on 10. Teams, are the scores fine? Alright? All teams agree? Right. We move to the next round, and before that, we move to the next round, that is Fast and the Curious. This is a buzzer round. All teams went from buzzer. A correct answer will give you plus 7. Okay? Okay, this is an audience question before that. As the plastic ban is gaining momentum in various around the world, companies are racing towards sustainable environmental substitutes to replace the conventional manufacturers in supply chain. One of the major industry gearing up to reduce plastic use is the milk industry, which is experimenting with PFY bags and pouches that can be used for 50-60 times and then recycled for further use. Now, what does PFY stand for? Audience, this yarn. Nice answer there. So we go to Fast and the Curious. No. It will be shown there on the screen. First question coming up. The emblem of which soccer club features the Eiffel Tower? That's a different thing, but whatever the bug is, see, listen, we can argue all day long, but at the end of the thing, five buzzers I can see. Okay, this is wrong, I know, only one should have buzzed, but whatever. Okay, all the teams pounce for this question only, for this question only. Write your answers, I'm coming. Okay. Team 1, press. Wait. Yeah, this we are done. What does this installation at Delhi Airport depict? Team 7 has...
Surya Namaskar.
Excellent. Team 7 gets 7 points. Installed at Indira Gandhi Airport Terminal 3. Yeah, this is SoundCloud. Team 2 gets 7. Next question. The man on the image is Neil Armstrong. Identify the woman. This team has pounced. Team 4, you have pressed the buzzer. Yeah, this is Valentina Tereshkova. Excellent answer. Team 4 gets 7 points. Next question. Which well-known brand was named after the youngest daughter of Kolkata-based entrepreneur Bishan Das Basil? Team 7.
Jyoti Pharmaceutical.
No. A minus 5 to Team 7. Not Tulsi. Audience, anybody? Audience? Nobody? Yeah? Not Bisleri. Not Rupa. 8. Not Lux. Okay, the answer is Usha, the fan company. Okay, next question. What 3D puzzle is the patent of?
It's a Rubik's Cube.
Yeah, it's the Rubik's Cube plus 7 to Team 3. Plus 7 to Team 3. And the next question coming up. Which quartet made a famous doing very well on the buzzer. And the last question. George Bernard Shaw is among the only two people to win an Oscar and a Nobel Prize. Who is the other person? Can I see? Team 2?
Al Gore.
Wrong answer. No, it's done. Anybody, audience here? Bob Dylan is correct. The answer is Bob Dylan. So team 2 gets a minus 5 on this question. Team 2 gets a minus 5. Yeah. Winning the Best Innovation Award, the Northeast Frontier Railway has adopted a unique strategy called Planned Dash to keep the wild elephants away from railway tracks. This involves setting up of devices with an amplifying system that emits a certain sound which is considered as a natural repellent of elephants. What sound does the devices generate? Do the devices generate? Yeah. Yeah, there. Guy with the hood.
Ultrasound.
Not ultrasound. Plan dash.
Plan B.
And B is what? How do you spell B? Yeah, this is Plan B. It emits the buzzing sound of bees. So, the elephants don't quite like that sound. So this is what the Northwest Frontier Railway has done. So can we have the scores, team? Yeah, after the finishing of third round, team 1 is on 67, team 2 on 49, Team 3 on 64, Team 4 on 61, Team 5 is on 7, Team 6 is on 47, Team 7 is on 39, and Team 8 is on 17. So the game is quite open till now. We have 10 more questions. This time going anti-clockwise. You can bounce on them and it will bounce as usual. Team 8. Question 1 of this round is for Team 8, coming up now. In 1905, Mary Anderson tried to sell the rights of her invention through a noted Canadian firm, but they rejected her application, saying, "We do not consider it to be of such commercial value as would warrant our undertaking its sale." After the plant, this was a direct for Team 8.
Airbags. Airbags.
7.
Handbrakes.
Not handbrakes. Team 6 had pounced. Team 5. Team 5. Passing. Team 4. Not safety belts.
The wipers of the car.
Excellent. These are the windshield wipers. So Team 3 gets plus 10. And Team 6 gets minus 10. Scorers, please note, Team 3 gets plus 10 and Team 6 gets minus 10. Bill served as an inspiration for this parody. Please play the video. Chariots of Fire is correct. And just a second. Team 1 and 8 get a negative of minus 10. Team 1 minus 10, Team 8 minus 10. Team number 2, 3, 4, 6 and 7, they get plus 10. Team number 2, 3, 4, 6, 7 get plus 10. Team number 1 and team number 8, they get a minus 10. And team number 5 did not attempt. Fine. Moving to the next question, 1982, it was hand-drawn over a period of 6 months by means of calligraphy pen and textured paper. Where was this font famously used in 2009? I'm closing the pounce in 3, 2, 1, pounce closed. Team number 2, 3 and 7 have pounced. Team 1, this is your direct?
Pass.
Pass. pass in team 8. Pass in team 6.
Avatar
is correct. This one, the typeface used for the subtitles that appear in the movie Avatar. Okay. So team 3, team 2, team 6 and 7. 2, 3, 6, 7 get plus 10. Team numbers 2, 3, 6, 7 get plus 10. So this was answered by team 6. Question for team 5. Team 5, these professionals are a common sight on the streets of Chengdu, China, and are part of a unique local tradition that is believed to date back many centuries. The Chengdu practice, Tao Air, as it's done here, is an elaborate 20 to 30 minute ritual featuring an array of specialized tools. Now, what do these masters do? Yes, closing the pounds. I close the pounds. Team number 7 and... Okay, he is making a clock. Okay, team 3...
Acupuncture, the acupuncture that...
No, this is not acupuncture. Team 1...
They are making chopsticks.
Okay, they are not making chopsticks. Team 8... No, team 7, you pounced. Team 6...
Is it fortune telling?
Not fortune telling, you meant fortune cookies. I mean, you meant fortune cookies, I suppose. No. No, this is not fortune telling. Audience, anybody? Ear cleaning. So, only team 7 got it on the pounds, plus 10 to team 7. Team 2 had pounced, and they have a minus 10. So, minus 10 to team 2, and a plus 10 to team 7. And this question was unanswered, so again for team 5. Next question for team 5. This brand originated in Switzerland and branded their name based on vitamin B5 as an ingredient that was made to produce it. They signaled through their advertisements that shine meant health, and this formulation provided real support for their claim. Vitamin B5 is commonly used as a moisturizer and to improve wound healing in pharmaceutical and cosmetic products. Now, which brand am I talking about? Vitamin B5? Anybody pouncing? No? Closing the pounds? Pounds closed. Team 5? Passing? Team 5 pouncing.
Oriflame.
Oriflame. No, this is not Oriflame. So it has so happened that two questions have gone unanswered from team 5. So the... So you need the scores once. The teams on stage need the scores once, as we have only a few questions left, 5 more left. So they want to see where they stand. Yeah. Team 5... got two directs, they couldn't answer. So this question is for you, and we will see the score after this question. Okay, team? Next question for team 4. In September 1997, a competition called Do a Design for X was launched by the Cystic Fibrosis Trust and supported by Portman Building Society. In March of the following year, a 12-year-old girl, Holly Wharton, was announced as the winner. It was later donated by the Roslin Institute in Edinburgh, Scotland, which has strong research links with the Cystic Fibrosis Trust. So what's so unique about this jumper? Yeah, I just need X. I'll close the pounds in 3. Obviously, if you know X or you give me what is so unique about it.
Wool of Dolly the clone ship.
Excellent. This is made from the wool taken from Dolly, which was the first cloned ship. So team number 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 7 get plus 10. Scorers, please note, team numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7. All these teams get plus 10 on this question. and we will see the scores and then move on to the next question. Four more questions to go after this. Yeah, just ask them to show the scores. Please bear with me for a minute. Okay, here are the scores. Team 3 is leading with 104 points. Team 4 is following closely with 81. Team 7 is again following closely with 79. And then there are again close calls. Team 2 on 69, Team 1 and Team 6, they are on 67. And Team 5 and Team 7, Team 8 are on 7 points. So it's still a chance for a podium finish for at least 5 of the 8 teams. So let's see how you fare in the last 4 questions. You see the video.
These spectacular, bizarre, bulging eyeballs are the snail's tentacles. Inside them, parasitic worms have begun an amazing feat of mind control. These parasites have taken over the snail's tentacles and its brain. It's all part of an ingenious plan to extend the life of the parasite and its offspring. The snail has become possessed. It is doomed now to follow the parasite's will. The parasite is on the move.
Okay, any team pouncing? Nobody pouncing? Closing the pounce, direct for team 3.
Are these zombie snails?
Excellent answer, these are the zombie snails. Plus 10 to team 3. Excellent answer, team 3. Next question to team 2. 8, 9, 10, 3 more. X is the biogeographical designation for a group of mainly Indonesian deep water straits from the Asian and Australian continental shelves. Named after the naturalist who recorded the differences between mammal and bird fauna between the islands on either side of the line. Now identify X or the naturalists. So you have to, for a pounce you have to, for team 2, team 2, your answer.
Raffles.
Yeah?
Raffles.
No, not that, team 1.
We'll pass.
Team 8 had pounced. Team 7?
Jacques Cousteau.
No. Team 6 had pounced. Team 5? Team 4 had pounced. Team 3?
Tasman. Abel Tasman.
Not Tasman. Audience, yeah?
Alfred.
Team 4 and 6 get plus 10 and team 8 gets a negative of minus 10. So the question again to team 2. Right? This went unanswered. Team 2, he earned a PhD in astrophysics from Imperial College London in 2007 and was Chancellor of Liverpool John Moores University from 2008 to 13. He was a science team collaborator with NASA's New Horizon Pluto mission. He is also co-owner of awareness campaign Asteroid Day. British cosmologist Martin Rees once said, "I don't know a scientist who looks as much like Isaac Newton as you do. Who am I referring to?" So I am closing the pounce in 3, 2, 1, pounce closed. Team number 2, 3, 4. So team 2?
Brian May.
Excellent. That is the correct answer. This is Brian May. He's the guitarist for Queen, the band. So team number 2, 3, 4 and 7 get plus 10 on this question. And I would again request the scorers to give us the scores. This is the last question of the quiz. So team 2, you got it correct. Last question of the quiz. Team 3 is leading on 124. Team 4 is on 101. Team 7 is currently on the third position at 89. Team 2 is on 79. Team 6 is on 77, team 1 is on 67, team 5 and 8 are on 7 and minus 3 respectively. So team 2 still has a chance of getting the third position, or there may be a tie for the third position. And if team 7 gets a negative, so team 2 may get the third position. A slight permutation combination. Last question of the quiz to team 1. One of the largest commercial buildings in Middle Ages, when it served as the main market and warehouse for the Flemish city's prosperous cloth industry. The original structure, erected mainly in the 13th century and completed 1304, lay in ruins after the artillery fire devastated Ypres in World War I. The design of which Indian building, established in 1862, was inspired by the design of Ypres Cloth Hall. I'll close the pounds in 3, 2, 1. Pounds closed. I can see all teams except 1 and 5 pouncing. Please write your answer. Team 1, this was a direct.
Calcutta High Court.
Indeed, it is the Calcutta High Court. So all teams except team 5 get a plus 10 on this question. And I'd request the scorers to show the scores. And are still here. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. A big round of applause to you all. And here are the scores. The team on the third position is team 7 with 99 points. A big round of applause for them. Team 4 is the runners-up with 104 points. Congratulations to all the teams. It will take five more minutes for the prize distribution ceremony, as we have to write the checks and all. So please wait for 5 minutes and all. We'll do it. Thank you so much.
Was